By now, everyone has heard of the drama surrounding the girl group April. Today, we will be looking over the situation closely and see why fans have been calling April members out regarding inconsistencies in their statements and the interview that changed the whole story. First announced by DSP Media on February 9, 2015, the South Korean girl group April debuted on August 24, 2015. April was composed of Somin, Taeyeon, Hyunjoo, Nayeon, Yena, Jinsil as the original lineup. Things were looking out for this girl group at the beginning with a bright future ahead of them. Due to health issues, Hyunjoo took a break from the group in 2016, and April continued as a four-member group. Later, Hyunjoo announced her departure from April after a seventh-month hiatus. Taekyun and Rachel were announced as new group members, but did Hyunjoo really leave the group to pursue acting, or was DSP Media trying to hide something? On February 28, 2021, an anonymous person claiming to be the brother of Hyunjoo claimed that Hyunjoo left the group because she was driven out after being badly mistreated by the other members and even contemplated taking her own. DSP Media denied that any mistreatment occurred and stated that they would take legal actions against Hyunjoo and her family. As a result, some members lost brand deals and even acting roles while the legal battle began. After 4 months of controversy, Nayeon released a lengthy statement on the fan cafe stating, "I never did that," and denied the charges of ever hurting Hyunjoo. Jinsil and Taeyeon shared that they never mistreated her too. The situation quickly accumulated and Nayeon, Taeyeon, Yena, and Jinsil came together to give an interview about this controversy. Sports Kyunyang News interviewed the four members involved in the dispute and they all confessed that they are seeking counseling after suffering terrible mental distress, but they are ready to break their silence. The four members all asserted that they were victims rather than the perpetrators. "We didn't do anything wrong and we're being cornered as wicked people, and we want to set things straight." Following the incident, Nayeon had to drop out of all projects as she was accused of starting the problem with Hyunjoo and it did hurt her financially. When asked why they had been quiet for so long, they said, "It's because the agency told us to stay still. We didn't do anything wrong, so we thought the truth would be revealed if we waited." The members explained why they consented to participate in the interview. They asserted that the agency's official statement and the members' post only seemed to deepen the misconception. Furthermore, when they saw Hyunjoo write, "I will forgive you if you admit your wrongdoings and try to make them right," they became angry and wanted to reveal the truth. The members discussed a wide range of topics, including the shoe and tumbler incident in which they had been accused of. They revealed that they had over 200 pairs of shoes kept at their house and they had no need to steal them. Because four of the members' shoe sizes were the same, they frequently mixed up their shoes and assumed they had worn the wrong pair rather than suspecting someone had stolen them. During the interview mentioned that Hyunjoo attempted to take her own because she was often ridiculed. They explained that her brother wrote that they recognized what they had done and apologized when she attempted to hurt herself. That was completely false and they had never seen or heard about this. The members did not apologize to her because they were unaware. If you think about it, who would ignore their own member when they're trying to take their own? "We would have naturally went to visit her right away. However, we didn't have cell phones and we didn't hear anything from the agency. We learned about the details after this incident." The members also stated that they tried to console Hyunjoo because she was having difficulty adjusting to living in the dorm, and that they even had a video of them celebrating her birthday. When asked if they spoke with Hyunjoo, they stated she always said that she didn't want to be an idol and that being one was difficult. She expressed an interest in becoming an actress. They continued, "Ever since Hyunjoo was a trainee, she always said that she was sick. She often missed practice and made it hard for us. She even missed two music show schedules." They also remembered how she missed her appearance at Music Bank. "We still clearly remember crying because she didn't show up before rehearsal and practicing the five-member version of the choreography in a hurry. She came back before the live show saying, 'I should still do the live broadcast.' Since then, we weren't able to appear on the broadcast station while promoting that song, and we thought we had been penalized." The girl shared another story of Hyunjoo missing one of the music shows for Tinkerbell activities. "She didn't appear on NBC's Show Champion. We didn't even know the reason. She didn't appear even before our live broadcast. And our manager told us to go back home. We took off all our makeup and hair accessories and headed back to our dorms crying. The next day, our agency said we have to work as a four-member group now. So we worked on the choreography all night long. Even at that time, we just thought Hyunjoo must be sick again." When asked about what happened before Lee Hyunjoo left the group, April members said that because Hyunjoo was having trouble adjusting to the dorm life, their agency permitted her to use her phone. They also gave her the freedom to travel back and forth from her home while she was promoting. The members, on the other hand, stated that they were having a hard time because Hyunjoo constantly claimed that they had stolen her items, despite the fact that nothing of the sort had happened when they reviewed the CCTV. Because such events were common, the members finally wrote their initials and phone numbers on their personal things and underwear. Another time, Hyunjoo accused Yena and Jinsil for tripping observing her in the practice room and in the hallway in front of the bathroom. But once again, when the CCTV footage was checked, no such actions occurred, and Hyunjoo then changed what she said to claim that she was hit in the bathroom with no CCTV. When questioned why they thought Hyunjoo did this back then, they implied that she was always ready to make a scene. But even though they tried hard to understand her, take care of her, and get along with her as one of the members of the same group because they wanted to protect April and Hyunjoo. For Hyunjoo's birthday on February 2016, before she left the group, we organized a birthday party for her. We turned off the lights and had a surprise party for her. And Hyunjoo was really happy when she was blowing out the candles. One of the members also talked about how she bought shoes for Hyunjoo when she didn't have any money and she was living off of her mother's allowance. She revealed that she placed the shoes in Hyunjoo's locker beside a note that read, "I wish you'll be happy, Oni." The members added, "Hyunjoo wore the shoes when she appeared on KBS 2 TV's The Unit." Nayeon came in front of a reporter with a notebook detailing the situation of the time of Hyunjoo's departure from the group in 2016 and a record sheet outlining the counseling she had over 5 months, from November 2015 to April 2016. Cheon also presented the documentation of her psychiatric treatment at that time. Due to Hyunjoo's insincerity and deceit, the two members were distraught to the point of wanting to take their own. According to the tape, to defend Nayeon, her older sister recently released images of some of the pages in her journal. However, one of the pages behind the picture looked to include a sentence criticizing someone, resulting in a larger public outcry against Nayeon. Wrapping up the interview, the members shared a few words that they wanted to say to Hyunjoo. "I don't know why she's forgetting all of the happy memories with the members and only having distorted memories. Because of this incident, our hard work from the past 7 years has come to nothing. We are in great pain and even our families are being criticized. We want to receive an apology from Hyunjoo who brought this situation about, and we want to tell her to return things back to the way they were with her own hands." On June 21, however, netizens pointed out that one of the photos used as evidence was wrong. The creator of the post explained, "Hyunjoo claimed she was being since she was a trainee, but the members refuted her claim, saying that they were close enough to take sticker photos together. The shot was taken in 2015, according to April. However, netizens claimed that it was taken in 2016 during the reality show April's My Wish. The sticker photos featured the brand Style Nanda, but Nayeon's clothing in the photo is similar to what she wore during the reality show. Fans observed other members holding their cell phones during Yeonha's middle school graduation in 2016. Despite the April members claiming in the interview that only Hyunjoo had access to her mobile between 2015 and 2017, Taewon reported that the members did not use their personal phones. However, the April members were photographed by fans using their phones after Yeonha's graduation in early 2016, shortly after the girl group's debut in August 2015. In a previous interview in August of 2017, the April members stated they had lived without cell phones for over 2 years. Though it was possible that they were not using their cell phones, netizens are saying that the decorations and accessories suggested that the April members were using them. The images presented in the interview implying that Hyunjoo and the April members had gotten along were also scrutinized. Fans argued that the pictures were reportedly taken during Chaewon's graduation in February 2016 because Chaewon wore the same scarf and had yellow flowers as Yeonha. Chaewon did not wear a scarf and had different flowers at her graduation. On June 23, law firm Lee & Kim revealed that Hyunjoo's younger brother had been cleared of slander charges by the police. The police decided after an inquiry that Hyunjoo's brother had no intention of slandering April. Instead, they assumed he wrote the post out of dissatisfaction over his sister's condition and a desire to expose the truth after hearing Hyunjoo declare she left the team of her own volition. The police also determined that Hyunjoo had been intimidated by the group and that the post's contents can be considered fake because they're close enough to the overall reality of the events while Hyunjoo and the members were both being promoted. As always, let me know in the comments what you guys think and who do you think is speaking the truth, or if you're staying neutral in this situation. But this is it for today's video. Bye!